Now, Chris, I've heard you brought something special. I wanted to leave it to the end. What you got? You got something real cool for us, right?
Keep in mind, it's confidential who I got it from, but a special friend, this is a sample. This was never released, never seen to the public.
Welcome to Mavs Fire Patrol. I'm your host, Brandon Barkley. If you're new here, we talk Mavs, we talk culture, we talk fashion. Of course, come on, we talk sneakers.
Heat.
All day long. We have Shelby here. How you doing? We have Chris, a.k.a. C. Hendo. How you doing, man?
How you doing?
Unless you're under a rock, if you've been to a Mavs game, you've seen her patrolling the sidelines. Shelby takes all those great photos you see after game days. And then Chris, he's a sneaker connoisseur, interviews guys all around the league about their kicks. Chris, what you got going on?
Man, a lot. You know, the Mavs bought in probably a sneaker god of the NBA and Luka. Keeping me busy this year. I love being in the Mavs locker room, and all the guys are bringing out heat this year, so I'm excited.
First things first, what's on your feet today, guys? What you got?
Yes, okay. So today I'm doing the Jordan 1s, all right? And then I did the high zip.
Okay.
I like a good laceless shoe, you know?
You know, I had to do something special for the Mavs Fire Patrol. I took it back 10 years, and there's a mutual friend that's with the Mavs family, and he was able to get this shoe for me, and it's 2009, so 10 years ago, the Shadow 1. Y'all see this right here? This is UNDS for you guys. I UNDS this shoe, so, man, like, it takes a lot for me to UNDS this shoe, so I got 4 pairs of this shoe. This is my favorite shoe ever.
What you got for us?
All right, I'm rocking some Vans, all right? I call them my July 4ths. All right, I'm real patriotic in these. I don't want to salute in these, you know. I only wear these on July 4th, so just like you, Chris, this is a special day. It's a special occasion.
Took them out of the reserves.
Yeah, these are my summer shoes, okay? I only wear it if it's 80 plus. So let's get into it, guys. Our topic today, we're talking about ins and outs of fashion. What's in, what's out. We're going to talk about the best collabs of 2018, and then we're going to wrap it up with some sneakers that are coming out this year. So let's talk first. What's the deal with this chunky shoe that's coming out? I call them the lawnmower shoes. So I feel like guys used to mow their lawns in them and get them real messed up, like the Monarchs and the thick dad shoes.
Yes.
That seems to be in right now.
It is, yeah. And, you know, Balenciaga with the triple S. Yeah, I don't think chunky shoes are going anywhere. I feel like it's more of a street look though. Because if you see our guys, or even some guys across the league, I don't really see them coming in with the chunky shoe, right? They're normally doing like the Nikes, the basketball shoe, the Jordans. But chunky's just very high fashion. It just like gives dimension to your wardrobe. So it's here to stay. I myself, not a fan. But
I get it.
But what do you think?
I am not a fan, but I'll tell you this. It's weird for me because if you took the Balenciaga name off the shoe, it's a Skecher.
Get in shape. Shape ups from Skechers.
Yeah.
It's a Skecher, right? And I get grief for this all the time. And you know, one crazy thing was this, if you guys remember back in the early or mid-2000s, Gilbert Arenas didn't have a shoe deal at that point. And he would just wear all designer shoes. I think he had a pair of like chunky shoes on and it was crazy. I'm like, man, that was a weird. And it's a wave, and like I said, it's probably gonna stay because we're in that generation now where everything retreads. When we say we don't like it now, it's gonna be back. So, yeah, I'm not a fan of it, but hey, if it got Balenciaga on it, I guess it's a go.
All right, guys, let's talk about the next trend, sock sneakers. Balenciagas, those kind of shoes. What do you think, Chris?
Once again, I can take it back with the N1 swim shoe. If you guys remember, N1 had a swim shoe.
Yeah.
And I'm not gonna lie to y'all, I was a part of that wave. Yeah. Remember going to the stores and man, they went before they hit Walmart, they went Foot Lockers. I had to get every single N1 swim shoe and I thought it was just great that I could run into the pool with the same shoe and walk around the house like it was a slipper. So I think it's great.
I like it. It's comfortable. It's not for me.
Oh, come on.
I can't get behind it.
Is it the colors? Not just too plain?
I think it's the bulk at the bottom and then like to the skinny, you know, grabbing the ankle. I just like pick one or the other.
Okay.
I either want like all sleek or all chunk.
Yeah, and you really can't wear them in the summer because I mean, they're more for a jogger or pants. If I see somebody
imagine
in shorts.
Imagine that with a short.
Yeah, if I see somebody with shorts on them, I'm not gonna lie, I might clown you. So please come with, you know, joggers, pants of fall time. Winter time is when you're gonna see people wearing these.
I'll say this, if I see anybody at the Mavs game and I see you with that on with shorts, I will personally give you a gift card to Nike. That is well documented right now. We're gonna get you some pants. Yeah, write that down because that, man, if you do that with some shorts, that's amazing. You can pull that off.
Well, I think those shoes is a perfect segue into laceless sneakers.
Yes.
that's been a really cool thing. You know, you got the Vapor Max, you got Adidas coming out with different shoes like that. Then obviously the Adapt shoe that just came out. It's really cool, right?
I like it. Yeah, the Vapor Max, the Mach, and then the Vapor Max Lite too. Those look really good. And I think we're gonna see more and more laceless coming out. And then especially like you said, the Mag, the Adapt, integrating technology for sure is gonna be just such a trend in 2019. I think we'll see more brands besides Nike, you know, trying to touch on that.
Yeah, for me, the Jordan 33 is a good example of that because they went laceless and they did the, it's kind of like a bungee cord kind of deal where it kind of like traps your foot in together. I think it's great. Once again, a guy who likes to wear shoes laced loose a little bit. I love that look. Yeah, like I said, the Nike Adapt does that and it has technology involved into it, which is great. So yeah, that's a go for me.
Now, what has been like the overall just feeling on those shoes, those Adapt? Guys, are they comfortable in them? Do they enjoy wearing them?
So I had a chance to talk to Jason Tatum about it and he said that for him, it's a cool technology thing. You're able to adjust the foot because the thing is this, most people have narrow feet or you have wide feet. And for me, I have wide feet. So the issue will be this. Most basketball shoes, as you see in front of us, are narrow. Some, the PGs, the LeBrons are more wide. I have an issue with narrow shoes, so I'm able to adjust that. Yeah. And the fact I can go to my smartphone or my iPhone or whatever and adjust what I want to do to that shoe, that's amazing. Because Luka had them on, and I know Luka wore them for like maybe a quarter or two, and he changed back to his PGs. And I think maybe it was the issue of just like, hey, it just didn't look as good or whatever. But I like the shoe. I think more colorways will help it out. Maybe Nike ID. That'll be a good idea.
Man, if they Nike ID those, get ready for everyone to have a pair, regardless of the price.
And I think what's going to be, might be a challenge is integrating that technology with comfort. That might have been why Luka took them off, I'm not sure. But yeah, I think whenever you're trying to, you know, connect an app with your shoe and itself to the lacing, like there's all those mechanics, technology you gotta put in that shoe. And so like, if this is bulky, you know, how you gonna move around and get them threes?
Right, exactly. Before we talk about one of the coolest collabs in 2018, let's kick it over to Fan Talk real quick. We're in the concourse checking out all the sneakers and asking fans what their favorite sneaker collab was of 2018. Let's see what they had to say. What was the best sneaker collab of 2018?
The best sneaker collab of 2018 got to be the Off-White collab with the Jordan 1s. Classic.
I would have to say the Air Max 97 Sean Witherspoon.
What was the best sneaker collab of 2018?
For me, it was the Off-White Vapor Max, the black pair.
Yeah, that's a clean pair. A lot of people rock those. A lot of people, you know, like to keep all this stuff on it. Do you keep all the stuff on, like the little tabs and all the little writing, all that stuff?
I took the tag off right away. I can't wear it. I had to take it off right away, but I mean, they still look great. It's one of the few wins I got on the sneakers app.
Yeah, really hard to get. Like, if you even get them, it's a win, right? Yeah,
absolutely, absolutely.
I'd probably have to go with Pharrell Williams Inspiration Pack this year. I think that was pretty fire with all the different colorways. He had about three or four of them. And just all the diversity that he has in every single shoe that he makes, along with Adidas, with how they do their partnership.
Well said. Appreciate you, man.
Thank
you. So now let's talk about the basketball shoes coming out this year. There's a lot all on the charts ready to come out. So we were blessed enough to have one pair right here that just came out. Chris, you want to tell us a little more about these?
Oh, yeah. So, you know, Paul George, once again, got his signature sneaker, the PG3. This PG3, I like the colors. I love loud colors, even though I'm wearing all black and gray today. I do love loud color sneakers. Nike is coming with it this year. Nike's in their bag, y'all. I'm telling y'all, they're, get ready. You better save your money up. Yeah. I think this is a great shoe for women. It almost reminds me of a runner. I was told an Andre Agassi type shoe, but you had that hyperdunk look in front of it on the midsole. But yeah, Nike is coming with it this year, y'all. I'm telling you.
It's awesome.
I am telling you, save your money.
There's like a story behind every shoe, right?
Yeah.
So it's iconic. Like, you got to get this shoe for nostalgia.
Yeah.
And the cool part about these are, obviously, Paul George from Palmdale, California, right? And that's actually where the NASA base is.
Yeah.
So he actually hosted, it just happened, he hosted a high school basketball game right by the base. All the guys were playing in this shoe.
Amazing.
I mean, the things Nike does that just maybe put them above other brands are things like that. A shoe based upon where the athlete's from and then having events centered around where they are, really cool. All right, guys. One of the coolest shoes from last year, the Nike Fear of God 1. It's coming out with a whole bunch of cool colorways. You know, Jerry Lorenzo wasn't just gonna leave it alone just with one colorway. So be on the lookout. There's gonna be a ton of different colorways. He even previewed one pretty recently. So what do you guys think? What are they gonna pull out this year?
I think what guys like PJ Tucker wearing them on the court is gonna help out a lot for the NBA.
We're gonna see a lot more of high fashion crossing over into basketball. but it's just going to be all about the, you know, does it work? Can I move in it?
Yeah.
All about the efficiency.
That's true.
Especially if you're going to pay, I guess for us, like, you know, if I'm going to pay that much, I just want to be seen in it. I'm not trying to, I'm not trying to cross over in it. Yeah. I'm just trying to just walk around for a little bit and then take my pictures, sit down.
That's so true. Guys, last November, it was announced something special. All right, it got freaky with Nike. I know you're wondering what the heck I'm talking about. All right, Giannis Antetokounmpo.
Knock, knock. Obama.
Obama who?
Obama, so.
Come on, man. Jesus Christ.
It's getting a signature shoe. Now, we don't know the exact release date, but we know he's getting one in the 2018-2019 season. The Milwaukee Bucks all-star, who's been around the league and obviously has brothers on our team, which is pretty cool as well, he's got a sneaker coming out. What do you guys think?
Well, I was able to see a prototype of a certain silhouette they were doing for his shoe, and you guys get ready. If you love movies, they're doing a theme for him. Once again, Nike is going in their bag for a theme. I think it's going to be great. And the good thing for Maverick fans is this. You got Costas. Costas.
My name is Costas, but a lot of people say Costas.
So Costas is going to get his own kind of pairs as well. So hopefully Nike does something where they bring it in stores here for us to get that shoe at a limited base or even unlimited base. So I think it's great.
I'm interested to see what his story is and what his, you know, theme is for that. You think it's going to be like just something real personal to him? And
when you think of Giannis, you got to think of just like unique. It has to be unique because he's a unique player. I mean, he has a rare size, rare build, rare skill set. I just like the fact that what they're going to do with this, they're doing a theme for him. And I can't say the actual movie. So just think of Giannis being an international guy coming to the United States. And keep that in mind.
Now, let's talk about the Yeezy basketball shoe. Now, if you're a hype beast, you obviously know. You know what Yeezy is. You know all the numbers. You know all the colorways. You know all the cool shoes. But now, a basketball shoe? What?
He's trying to do everything. So it's reflective. If you've seen the images, like what it's looking like, is that good for on the court? Like, is that allowed?
Well, 3M has always been around in basketball shoes. I mean, the Jordan 5s had 3M on them. So I don't think that's an issue because at that point, you're just flashing the camera to get that 3M look. I don't think it's an issue for me personally, but I can't imagine Kanye selling a basketball shoe. The connection on basketball is kind of weird because Kanye doesn't have a basketball connection. So how does that work?
Basketball and high fashion. Like, everybody's trying to do it.
They go hand in hand. Now, Chris, I've heard you brought something special. This, you know, I wanted to leave it to the end. What you got? What you got? You got something real cool for us, right?
Keep in mind, it's confidential who I got it from, but a special friend, you know, won a couple of championships, right? You guys see this shoe. It looks basic, right? The colors stand out a little bit. This is an Under Armour Curry 3 Low. This is a sample. This was never released, never seen to the public. This is a rare shoe for me, man. Out of everything in my collection, I think this is most important for me because it was the beginning of something for him. And like I said, this is dope. If you're into basketball, definitely Under Armour is a good way to go. But this is a sample. It's a size 12 sample. Just keep that in mind. For all you thinkers out there, whose shoe this could be, I mean, it's a Curry Low. Let's make it obvious, right? So it's one of my favorite shoes, man, in my collection.
Awesome, awesome. Well, Chris and Shelby, I appreciate you guys coming on. We appreciate the fans for supporting us. Let's keep it rolling. Let's keep it rolling. All right, guys. I'm Brandon. I'm your host. This is Mass Fire Patrol. Leave in the comments below what you want to see next. We'll see you next time.